worship is from Psalm 119. Righteous are you, O Lord, and your laws are right. The statutes you have laid down are righteous. They are fully trustworthy. Your promises have been thoroughly tested, and your servant loves them. Though I am lowly and despised, I do not forget your precepts. One of the traditional creeds in the Christian church is the Apostles' Creed. Let us unite in saying this historic confession of the Christian faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose again from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Today's passage is from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 25, 14 through 30. Again, it will be like a man going on a journey who called his servants and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents of money, to another 2 talents, and to another 1 talent, each according to his ability. Then he went on his journey. The man who had received 5 talents went at once and put his money to work and gained 5 more. So also the one with 2 talents gained 2 more. But the man who had received the 1 talent went off, dug a hole in the ground, and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants returned and settled accounts with them. The man who had received the 5 talents brought the other 5. Master, he said, you entrusted me with 5 talents. See, I have gained 5 more. His master replied, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness. The man with 2 talents also came. Master, he said, you entrusted me with 2 talents. See, I have gained 2 more. His master replied, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness. Then the man who had received the 1 talent came. Master, he said, I knew that you are a hard man, harvesting where you have not sown, gathering where you have not scattered seed. So I was afraid and went out and hid your talent in the ground. See, here is what belongs to you. His master replied, you wicked and lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I have not sown and gather where I have not scattered seed. Well then, you should have put my money on deposit with the bankers so that when I returned I would have received it back with interest. Take the talent from him and give it to the one who has 10 talents. For everyone who has will be given more, and he will have an abundance. Whoever does not have even what he has will be taken from him. And throw that worthless servant outside into the darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth.
Thank you.
often read this scripture passage from Matthew 25 in the context of taking risks in life. What happens to us when we risk, dare, adventure in God's kingdom? Well, let's first ask what happens if we do not. The third servant who did not take the risk was thrown into the outer darkness. The prophet Zephaniah pronounced God's word of judgment against those who had become apathetic in their faith. And it will come about at that time, I will search Jerusalem with lamps, and I will punish those who are stagnant in spirit, who say in their hearts, the Lord will not do good or evil. Stagnant in spirit. What a great phrase. The image which Zephaniah uses comes across better in the Hebrew. He uses the image of the thick coagulation which forms over the wine in a wine vat when it has not been stirred up. It's like I had a friend who would make a great bowl or a great pot of chili and set it overnight on the back porch to let the fat rise. When you let something sit still, when you let chili sit still, the fat rises to the top. Not to risk or dare or adventure in faith is to become stagnant in spirit. For a church to become stagnant in spirit means that it has let the fat rise to the top. And we enter the outer darkness when we dare not risk. The great nothingness. Not to risk, dare, adventure, and faith is to lose the image of Christ in one's life. But what if we do dare? What if we do risk in God's kingdom? Well, it's very simple. In our parable today, the master rewarded the two servants who risked with two things. First, he gave them more to risk, more to do in the kingdom. He trusted them more. And then second, he said, enter into my joy. This is what God does for us who risk, who dare in His kingdom. First, God gives us more to risk. God believes in us more, has greater trust in us. And then second, we share in the joy of God, abundant and eternal joy. Through our faith in God, we are given much. Through God's faith in us, much is expected. We are expected to risk what we have. What we have been given, and enter into the adventure of God's kingdom. With the risk, we enter into the joy of God. We are invited to enter into God's kingdom of risk and share in the joy of God.
I love to tell the story of unseen things above, of Jesus and His glory, of Jesus and His love. I love to tell the story because I know 'tis true. It satisfies my longings as nothing else can. I love to tell a story, 'twill be my theme and glory, to tell the old, old story of Jesus and His love. I love to tell the story for those who know best. Same hungering and thirsting to hear it like the rest. And when in scenes of glory I sing the new song, 'twill be the old, old story that I have loved so.
Thank you.